everybody. Good morning and welcome to Body Beautiful. This is the show where we chit-chat with local professionals about the very latest in cosmetic procedures and medical devices. We also take your calls live on the air. With us today, we have plastic surgeon Dr. Joseph Mele. Welcome back to the program, Doctor.
Nice to be here.
We're talking about breast augmentation, a very popular surgery.
It's the most popular surgery.
Yeah. But
it's taken over the last 2 years.
Has it?
Yeah.
It's
it
number one?
It used to be sort of neck and neck with eyelids for second and third position, but over the last 2 years, it's been number one, clearly.
Okay, neck and neck, so to speak, or
yes.
A little bit lower than the neck.
Just a little.
But you're talking about revision surgery. This doesn't mean fixing botched jobs.
It can, but there's a certain amount of maintenance that comes with breast augmentation.
Okay,
and
so
it's
this
very
is
important when you're considering the operation, especially the first time around, that you discuss what could happen that may need to be fixed at some point in the future, even if everything's done perfectly well.
Okay, well, maybe that's a myth. I mean, the idea that you go in and you have the augmentation and then that's it for the rest of your life? No.
For many people, that's true, but implants themselves are not lifetime devices. There's always a chance that they could deflate. There's a chance that the body could form excess scar around the implant where the implant becomes tight or the breast feels tight, or it may be tight just on one half and push the implant and move it out of position.
Or, dare I say, do you have some patients that say, while I'm so happy with this size, I think I'm going to graduate to the next size?
Yeah, going a little bit larger is the more common of the directions.
Really?
And I think if I pinned down most of my patients and told them you had to be bigger or smaller, the majority of them would want to be just a little bit bigger.
Do you draw the line? Because so many of the tabloid shows, we see some people who don't apparently have a line. Do you do that with your patients? Do you say, okay, you need to dial it back?
Well, I'm a professional, so I try to provide guidance. I don't say you can't do, you can do, but I try to explain reasons why you might not want to. And certainly you want things to fit into clothing, you want to be proportionate. Most people are pretty happy to do that. Most of my patients are not looking to make a statement with their breasts. They just want their volume back after pregnancy or after weight loss. They want to fill their clothes out and not have to do anything special.
There is something that happens to, you know, a woman's self-esteem, psyche, and, you know, certainly so much in this culture is focused on the breasts. Do you find that that happens with your patients, that, you know, that it isn't just the physical transformation, but something happens with, you know, how they view themselves in the world?
Well, I think it really is internalized. And it's interesting because a lot of patients, if we look at the before and after pictures after we've done surgery, they don't like the before pictures. They don't even remember them. They've sort of blanked it out of their minds. And I think that's part of the healing process. That's part of sort of moving forward and just not worrying about it.
Okay, we have some photos. We're going to need to take a break. So at some point, we'll get to those in the next break. But I wonder how many of these are optional, the revisions, and how many are actually mandatory?
Probably about a third. About a third of them are optional. That is, a third of the folks that I'm doing revisions on are changing size, sometimes going smaller, but the majority of the time going a little bit larger. And I'm not talking about doubling their size, just to get into a happy zone.
All right, so by mandatory, though, that you really need to go in to correct something?
Well, certainly, if there's a deflation, the implant should be replaced. With the saline implants, it's pretty obvious because the volume is lost. The breast is flat or smaller, so we want to fix that usually sooner than later. A lot of times the story I'll get is, you know, yesterday it was a little bit softer, today it's gone. I haven't eaten, can we do this today? They want it fixed now. With the gel implants, it's more difficult. Since they have sort of a sticky gel inside, even if the implant has a small hole in it, from the outside it's very difficult to tell because the volume is maintained. But if we find out there's a leak, we definitely want to go in there and fix it.
Now, there used to be a huge controversy, and that's why the saline implants came into play.
Well, they were always in play. I mean, I think saline and gel, the silicone gel-filled implants, were used about 50-50 before there was the controversy. When the FDA restricted the use of the gel implants, saline was the only option. So it seemed like they suddenly came on the scene, but they were always there. And we're kind of back to that now, maybe 60-40 saline versus gel, or 50-50, somewhere in that ballpark.
Yet there's a discernible difference between the two, just in terms of what they're like. I mean,
The big advantage of the gel implants is how they feel. So while in clothing, looking at the breasts, they appear pretty similar. The saline is a little bit stiffer, so because it has a little bit of pressure inside. So if you're laying down, they tend to stand up a little bit more. Mm-hmm. The gel tends to collapse a little bit better.
Well, we have a lot of phone calls coming in and also some pictures, so we need to take this quick break. But for more information about Dr. Joseph Mele, you can call him, 925-943-6353, or check him out on the web at drmele.com. We'll be taking your phone calls and continue our chat about breast augmentation revision surgery when we come back on Body Beauty.
The information and advice given on this program is for general informational purposes only. For medical advice on specific treatments, medical professionals should be consulted. You should not initiate a course of treatment without consulting a qualified doctor.